بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. We are still in the series of Qurban and the season of Eid al-Adha and the inner dimensions of this important ibadah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Hajj, verse number 37, لَنْ يَنَالَ اللَّهَ لُحُومُهَا وَلَا دِمَاؤُهَا وَلَكِنْ يَنَالَهُ التَّقْوَى مِنْكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this verse that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the meat of this sacrifice will not reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will not benefit from the meat of our sacrifices and our qurban. But what will reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the taqwa. So let us really focus on the taqwa. This is another reminder of taqwa, which is the ultimate fruit of ibadah. Look at all the ibadat in Islam. The ultimate purpose is to attain taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ramadan just finished 2 months ago or so. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about fasting, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Allah says in this verse in Surah Al-Baqarah, O you who believe, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prescribed fasting for you as He prescribed it for the people before you, so that you may attain taqwa. And here is in Qurban al-Udhiyah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, taqwa that will reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let us make this season and this occasion as another reminder for taqwa. And remember, my brothers and sisters, our Qurban is their Qurban, the need is Qurban. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.